everyone, welcome back. I hope you all are fine and safe. So in this video we are going to see the solution of chapter number 15, hot or cold, or from question number 5. Answer the following questions. Number 1, how do you cool some food when it is too hot? Answer, when some food is too hot, I cool it by blowing on it through my mouth, or I just let it be for some time, or I keep it under a fan to cool it. Next, number 2, why does a mirror become moist and hazy when we blow air on through our mouth? Answer, the air that we blow out through our mouth is warm and the mirror is cold in comparison. The warm air that we breathe out contains water vapor. When this water vapor comes in contact with the cold mirror, it is turned into tiny droplets of water. This makes the mirror moist and hazy. Next, number 3, if you have to cool these 3 hot things, dal, roti or rice, in which ways would you do so? Answer, I would take the dal and pour it from one bowl into another and back again. By doing this for some time, I will cool the dal. I will make 4 pieces of the roti and then blow on it to cool it. I will take the rice in a dish and spread it into a thin layer to cool it. Next, number 4, we blow air to cool hot things as well as to warm them. Give one example of each. Answer, an example of a hot thing becoming cool on blowing on it. By blowing on a hot pakora, it cools down quickly. An example of a cold thing becoming warm on blowing on it. By blowing hard and continuously on a finger that have become cold due to holding ice, they warm up quickly. Next, number 5, how does the air from the mouth help in cleaning the spectacles? Answer, due to the moisture that is present in the air coming out from the mouth, the glasses becomes hazy. These are extremely small droplets of water. On wiping with the clean cloth, the glasses become clean. Next, question number 6, answer the asked. Number 1, for which other activities do you blow air from your mouth? Answer, I blow air from my mouth to do the following activities. Number 1, to whistle. Number 2, to light the chula with the pipe. Number 3, to remove dust from clothes or other things. Number 4, to clean spectacle glasses. Number 5, to rotate a pinwheel. And number 6, to inflate a balloon. Now, number 2, can you name some things which produce melodious and pleasing sounds when we blow into them? Answer, yes, I can name some things which produce melodious and pleasing sounds when we blow into them. They are as follows: the flute, the bean, the shehnai. Next, question number 7, classify the following musical instruments into those played by blowing air through the mouth or by creating vibrations by striking stretched leather or strumming wires. Flute, dholak, bean, tanpura, pava, mouth organ, guitar, sitar, bagpipe, mridang. Instruments played by blowing air are flute, bean, pava, mouth organ, bagpipe. Instruments played by striking stretched leather are dholak, mridang. Instruments played by strumming wires, tanpura, guitar, sitar. Next, we have activity number 2, make a whistle. Make a whistle of the things given below, write in the sequence from the loudest to the softest whistle. Number 1, wrapper of a toffee. Number 2, a leaf. Number 3, a cap of a pen. Number 4, a balloon. So here you have to whistle all these 4 things, and the one that makes the loudest, you have to put in the number 1, then number 2, then number 3, and then the softest one in the number 4. Next, number 3, the clock inside you. You have all heard the tick-tick of the clock. Have you seen a doctor using a stethoscope to listen to your chest? Where does the sound come from? Is there a clock inside your chest that keeps ticking away? Have you ever listened to your heartbeats? Take a rubber tube as long as the distance from your shoulder to your elbow. At one end of the tube, fix a funnel. Place the funnel on the left side of your chest. Put the other end of the tube to your ear. Listen carefully. Did you hear a thug-thug sound? Note down your observation and experience. Answer: yes, I have seen a doctor using a stethoscope to listen to my chest. This sound comes from the heart that is situated on the left side of our chest. Our heart beats continuously. Our heart beats continuously in our body. It is an organ that is located in the left side of our chest and which ticks continuously like a clock inside our body. Next, number 4, flow of air. Number 1, for this, take a round shaped paper of 10 to 15 centimeter radius. Cut this paper in a spiral shape as shown in the picture. Number 2, to hold this snake, tie the thread on its head side. Number 3, tie the knot to make it hang. Now the snake is ready to move. Number 4, take this snake near a hot thing. For this, you can take hot tea, hot water, or a burning candle. Now see from the top in which direction the snake moves. Number 5, whenever the air flow upwards, it will move up. It will move in a clockwise direction. When the air flows down, the snake will move in the opposite direction. Number 6, stand with the snake below a fan. Look in which direction it moves. Take this paper snake to different places and observe its movement. Can you understand from the movements of the snake if the air is moving upward or downwards? Note your observation. Answer: yes, when the snake moves in the clockwise direction, rotation, I can understand that air that is below flows in the upward direction. And when the snake moves in the anticlockwise direction, rotation, I can understand the air that is above flows in the downward direction. Next, we have Hort's questions. Choose the correct alternative from those given below each question and write its index letter in the box provided against each question. Number 1, what is the effect on a hot thing when we blow on it? A, it becomes hotter. B, it cools down. C, it becomes light. D, there is no effect. Answer is B, it cools down. Number 2, what did Mian Balishtiye think the woodcutter was? Options: A, a magician. B, a ghost or a jinn. C, a wild animal. D, a celestial being. Answer is B, a ghost or a jinn. Number 3, which musical instrument is played by creating vibrations on stretched leather? Options: A, a flute. B, the cymbals. C, the tabla. D, the sitar. Answer is C, the tabla. Number 4, what is a stethoscope used for? Options: A, to count a person's breaths. B, to count a person's heartbeat. C, to measure the temperature. D, to measure blood pressure. Answer is B, to count a person's heartbeats. So here we complete the solution of chapter number 15. If you have any doubt, query or suggestions, let me know in the comment section. I will see you in the next video with a new chapter. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.